now we are at Giza area, Giza plateau. It dates back to around 25 centuries BC. All the pyramid before was smooth from outside, covered with fine limestone from Tura, from the other side of the Nile. The sun, when it gives the rays on the earth, it takes the shape of a pyramid. The rays of the sun, when come on the planet earth, it take a shape of a pyramid. That's why they choose the shape of the pyramid to be like a staircase for the soul of the king to reach the heaven. This pyramid, it's considered to be the biggest pyramid ever in Egypt. Around 100,000 workers work for this pyramid for 20 years to be built. They are not slaves, because when we discover the cemetery of the workers here, we notice that the king Ethiopians use a lot of people around all Egypt during the 3 months of the flood time. During the 3 months of the flood time, a lot of people don't work because there is no agriculture in this time. That's why he collected them and began to give them salaries to work for building his pyramid. That's why it was the first solution for unemployment in the whole history. Okay, now we are on the eastern side of Cheops pyramid or Khufu pyramid. Here we discover 5 big holes inside the ground which have some of the solar boats which we discovered. Here in 1954, one called Kamal el-Mallakh, he was Egyptian archaeologist, came here and he was cleaning beside the pyramid. And while he is cleaning, he began to find very big rocks made out of limestone, and it was found together beside each other. And we are lucky to discover one of the solar boats of King Ethiopia. We have it nowadays, it collected again with the same original shape without anything. It's a very huge boat. It's around 44 meter long and around 6 meter wide. It have around 12 paddles, 10 responsible for moving the boat and 2 responsible for the directions of the boat. Very big. When we discover it, it's not like the boat nowadays. No, we discover it into pieces, small pieces, around 12-24 pieces. We bring all of them back. They made out of cedar, which we imported from Syria and Lebanon, because in Egypt we don't have cedar trees. They imported to make the huge boats of the king. Why we name it with solar boat? Because they use these boats to bring the body of the king from the eastern side to the western side. Because the ancient Egyptians use always the western side as tombs for themselves. Because one of the main gods in this time was the sun god, and they believe that they are going to born like the sun in the east and die like the sun in the west and reborn again in the afterlife. That's why they began to use the western bank of the Nile to have the pyramids and tombs. That's why during the mummification time, after they mummify the body of the king, they use these ships to bring the body of the king from the eastern side to the western side here to put it inside the pyramid. After that, they cut the boats or the ships into pieces and buried beside the king, because they think that the king is going to use the ship again during his journey to the afterlife, because his soul will use this ship to pass through the afterlife until he reach the god of the afterlife. In this time, just using it for bringing the body of the pharaoh from the eastern side to the western side, and also some scholars say that they are using it for the journeys of the king. But the most important thing is not the symbol used for the daily life, but also because it have religious view for them. That's why they made this boat and buried beside the king, because they think the king must have it to reach the afterlife. If he don't have this solar boat, how he will go to the afterlife? That's the main reason they build it. After that, they use it during the daily life of the king and put it here beside him.
Sailing the boat from East Bank, from the side of life, to come here to visit the temple, make a celebration and a big party for the annual festival day of the temple. So this scene here showing us the festival day of the temple. So all that is the Egyptian army soldier, they come here, they are not fight, but they are dancing with a stick. Even the king is dancing himself. And this court, it's a big record for the famous journey to Somalia to discover Africa. Hatshepsut, she sent a people with a sailing boats to the south to discover Africa. The boats start to sailing by the River Nile until they arrive to the shortest distance between River Nile and the Red Sea. Then they keep sailing down by the Red Sea to the south. So the sailing boats sailing through two kinds of water, sweet water, River Nile, and salt water from the Red Sea. So within the journey, there was an artist. When this artist came back, he record for us here whatever he have seen, even small details or funny details. And you can see as well coconut tree. Coconut tree. And you can see incense tree. When the Egyptians decided to go home, come back again to the Egyptian land, they bring with them a lot of stuff.
And here you can see the transportation of the trees, how they brought it. They brought it in baskets, like with plants, and after that they began to plant it here again. So they didn't bring the trees as seeds, no. They bring the tree itself and began to plant it here. To transfer it, they must do the big boats from cedar wood, which we imported from Lebanon and Syria. And here you can see the solar boats, or the boats which they used, is the same shape of the solar boat of King Cheops. So it dates back to 4,400 years from now. Here you can see a lot of men while they are sitting inside the bark. It's the same kind of the boat which we saw. You can see the robes of the blood here. If you look here, why they are cutting this timber? Because they are going to use it in making the boat. Okay? Here, while they are using some tools and they bring some timber and begin to try to shape it. Also at the bottom, a piece of timber, big one, and they're using some small tools to carve it and cut it. This is the uses of the wood during the time. Yeah. And here they succeeded in beginning to collect the boat. You can see the people are working on the boat, cutting it, and finishing all the parts together. Here he is holding his hand, because he is using the chair to put the pieces. Also the shapes here, it's not only one part, you can see it's different parts, like we saw the solar boat, and after that they intersect them together using the ropes. It's the same way. Maybe this synthesis is one of the most important, because it shows us how they make the boats. Here they made a table from the wooden stuff, and they are polishing it to be smooth, using some ropes to polish the wood. And here, using two pieces of wood to make a hole inside this box and make it round. All these are wooden tools and also wooden furniture. They use the wood in making everything in this time.